Oh? You want to hear another tall tale from the high seas, do you?
No, not another pirate story. I want to hear about dragons and knights in shining armor.
Dragons, you say?
Over the last decade, developer Image and Form has been turning out innovative and fun spins on familiar genres through their SteamWorld series. Taking place on a world entirely populated by steam-powered robots, SteamWorld Dig and SteamWorld Heist took the templates of a Metroidvania and a turn-based strategy game, respectively, and put them through a steampunky filter. The resulting games were not just fun, but also offered something entirely new to fans of the genres. On top of that, Image and Form's art design has been simply delightful, with brilliant sprite work full of personality and imagination. In their latest game, SteamWorld Quest: Hand of Gilgamesh, the stunning sprites and beautiful world are still there, but innovation with the RPG genre was, unfortunately, lacking. Tell me if you've heard this one before. After a mysterious army attacks their village, a plucky band of young heroes must leave their home on a quest, uncovering secrets of a dark conspiracy, meeting quirky new allies, and learning about themselves along the way. That's about as generic a plot as you can find in a fantasy RPG, and it's the plot of SteamWorld Quest. There are no twists or turns that subvert expectations of this well-trodden tale. It's fantasy paint by numbers, right down to the search for the mysterious artifact that could destroy the world. The linear nature of the game is also disappointing. The story is divided into self-contained chapters, with no real character choice or role-playing involved. You do have the option to go back and replay chapters to find treasure you may have missed or grind for money and experience, yet there's no real incentive to do so, as you'll have to play through all of the same events again. The battles in SteamWorld Quest are a fun and effective mix of turn-based and card-based combat. You equip your heroes with cards, much like you would with weapons and accessories. At the beginning of each battle, you draw six at random. By playing low-powered cards, you build up gears that act similarly to MP, allowing you to use more powerful abilities and attacks. By selecting the right cards in the right order, you can even chain your abilities together, giving you additional and enhanced effects. It's a very effective battle system that builds on other card-based RPGs that have come out in the last few years. Aside from a very unbalanced endgame with a sharp difficulty spike, battles are always enjoyable. Experimenting with different card loads to find one that will cover all of your bases so you can swiftly crush your enemies is super fun. Plus, there's an option to speed up battles, which is a welcome quality of life addition. One area where SteamWorld Quest definitely lives up to its predecessors is in the graphics department. The unique aesthetic of the SteamWorld games is on full display here, with beautifully drawn robotic characters shining with personality and polish. The team at Image and Form have wonderfully adapted traditional fantasy class tropes, giving them a robotic twist. The classes of Alchemist Copernica, or wannabe Knight Armalee, are instantly identifiable with just one look, and every other character design, including the NPCs, are just brimming with personality and charm. I was a bit disappointed that many of the bosses and mini-bosses were palette swaps of each other, but on the whole, the graphics are flat-out gorgeous. Another great aspect of SteamWorld Quest is its sound design. The soundtrack is lovely, evoking memories of other classic fantasy tales, while giving everything a robotic twist. Each character speaks in robotic gibberish, nicely contributing to the juxtaposition of the fantasy elements with the steampunk level of technology. In the end, SteamWorld Quest feels much more like a polished mobile game than a console RPG. This game is beautiful, not too long, pleasant, and fun to play in short bursts. But those looking for deep character growth, an explorable world, and a compelling story should look elsewhere. It's a rare misstep from Image and Form, but, given their past output, I suspect it's one they will learn from. SteamWorld Dig 2 took everything great about the original and improved upon it. Let's hope the same happens with SteamWorld Quest, should it get a sequel. Have you played SteamWorld Quest? Let us know in the comments below what you thought. Also, like and subscribe to keep up to date as the channel grows. And be sure to check out RPGFan.com for all of your RPG news, reviews, and discussion.